Hi kids, my name is Pradnya and today I am here with a very important story. The name of the story is The Mystery of the Cyber Friend. It's written by Zach Oya and it's illustrated by Nilofer Wadia. Shri lives in a small apartment in a small town called Katpadi Junction. Amma works in a jewelry store and Appa works as a taxi driver. They want her to learn computers, so they are very pleased that she likes to use it. The computer is Shri's friend. She always finds time for it. She uses it to find information for school projects and to send emails. Shri's aunt also stays with them. Everyone calls her Akka. Most of the time, she naps in front of the TV watching her favorite old movie. She gives Shri hot dosas stuffed with spicy noodles. After tiffin, Shri likes to play. Not the traditional games like Akka with stones and shells. Shri likes to play games on the computer. The computer doesn't just have games, it also has FriendsNet. Shri joined it 2 months ago on her 13th birthday. After snacks and tea, she chats with her school friends through FriendsNet. They tell each other what they did since they last met on the school bus. Shri says that she got extra sugar with her tea. One friend says, "That you get every day." Another friend teases, "Do you do anything other than eating?" Shri gets angry. She decides to unfriend them. Afterwards, she misses them. But before she can tell them that she's sorry, she gets a new friend request. It's from a girl called Chaitra. She's very pretty, like a film star. Shri clicks accept. One click and they become friends. Chaitra types, "Do you have many friends?" "No, and I lost a few friends today," she adds, sad face emoticon. "So what? It really doesn't matter how many friends you have. It is the nature of our friendship that matters. And you have me now." Shri likes the sound of that. "Where do you go to school?" types Shri. "Near your school," types Chaitra. "How do you know which school I go to?" wonders Shri. "Because it is near my school." "That is nice. Then we can meet," types Shri. Chaitra signs off. "Yes, and we will be best friends forever. Bye." The next morning, Shri looks for a school near hers, but she cannot see one. It is a little strange that she hasn't heard of any other school nearby. But Chaitra is nicer than all her friends. She is Shri's special friend and nobody else's friend. Today, she doesn't touch the hot noodles, though they are her favorite, chili chicken. Akka wonders what is wrong. "Are you feeling unwell?" "Too much schoolwork," lies Shri. "Then you go and finish your homework while I take my nap," says Akka. But Shri doesn't do her homework. Instead, she starts the computer, goes online and waits for her friend to ping her. Soon, she gets a message from Chaitra. "Hello friend, how are you today?" "I'm fine. I didn't eat my tiffin," types Shri. "Why?" types Chaitra. "Because I wanted to talk to you, so I finished tea quickly," types Shri. "Great. Now, can you send me a selfie and give me your number so I can call you?" types Chaitra. "I don't have a camera phone," types Shri and feels sad. Chaitra offers to give Shri her old camera phone. "Let us meet on Sunday, then I will take your snap and give you my old phone." She has always wished for a phone with a camera. She types, "Where shall we meet?" Chaitra types, "Come to the railway station." Shri asks, "What time?" Chaitra decides, "When the Bengaluru train reaches there." Akka comes into the room just then to clean it. "What are you doing, Shri?" "I have a new friend, Akka." Akka looks over Shri's shoulder and Chaitra's profile picture. "But that's the film actress I like so much, Madhu." "She's your friend?" "Yes, but her name is Chaitra." Akka laughs and shakes her head. "That's Madhu. I have seen all her films. She must be old now." "She's the same age as me," insists Shri. "No, no, she's as old as I am," says Akka. "That snap was taken when she was still in school. It is from her first movie." Shri is very angry with Akka, then stops to think. Is Chaitra using someone else's picture, a film star's? "How old are you?" she types. "I told you I am 13, the same age as you," Chaitra types back. Shri replies, "That is good. Best friends should be the same age." "Hey, the earrings in your profile picture are so pretty," types Shri. "Thanks, I made them myself." "Wow, wear them tomorrow when we meet." "Okay, but only if you come alone," says Chaitra. "Why?" types Shri. "Because I am coming alone too, to our secret meeting." Shri is typing, "Okay," when she remembers something. "Hey Chaitra, I haven't seen any other school near our school." But Chaitra has gone offline. Is there something strange about her new friend? Has she been lying? Shri is very confused and cannot focus on her homework. "Akka," she asks. "Yes, my dear," says Akka. "What is worrying you?" Shri decides to be honest and tells her all about her new friend who is lying. "Akka, what should I do?" The next day, Shri and Akka reach Katpadi Junction much before the arrival of the Bengaluru Express. They have a secret plan to find out if the new friend is honest or not. Akka says, "I will go and talk to the station manager so he can help us." The train from Bengaluru is coming in. Shri looks all around. She can't remember whether Chaitra had asked her to wait inside the station or outside the station. Where did Akka go? She can't see her anywhere. Many passengers come out of the train. None look like Chaitra. A man who's her father's age walks towards Shri. He is smiling. "Hello, Shri." Shri is shocked. She doesn't know him. "It is so nice to see you," he says. "Who? Who are you? You are not Chaitra," stutters Shri. "No, but I am an uncle and would like to be your friend. I like to make friends with young girls," says the uncle, who is not Chaitra. "Eee!" shrieks Shri. Akka is beside her in a second, along with the station manager. The uncle, who is not Chaitra, is surprised. He didn't expect that Shri would bring along with her two adults. Akka hits him with her handbag. Then she yells, "Don't you dare come near my niece!" "Ow!" he cries. Just then the train moves. He runs towards the bogie door. The station manager rushes forward to catch the man, but he disappears into the crowd. They all go to the police station. "You are a brave girl," says the policewoman. "Thank you for informing us about this imposter. Shri, you were very clever to confide in a trusted adult. Will you put up this poster about cybersecurity in your school, please? We would also like to conduct a cybersecurity class in your school. She says an expert from cybercrime cell will need to take a look at Shree's computer. The next day, a cybercrime officer goes through Shree's computer. Within hours, the police find the man who pretended to be Chaitra. They nab him from his office in Bangalore and find that he has been trying to befriend many young girls and boys on social media. Shree decides to only have friends from her own school. She can't wait to tell her friends about her scary adventure with her cyber friend. So I would like to request that you please be safe online, and there is a child helpline number which will, if you feel that there is anything unsafe happening around you or someone you know, you can call on this number, and the number is 1098. I understand that the internet is a wonderful technology and it can help us in many ways. But as you just saw in this story, it can also be very, very, very dangerous. So there are a few things which you can keep in mind because you are not an adult, so that the way you use internet becomes safe for you. Number one, do not give your name, address, school name, telephone number or email ID to any stranger online. Do not send your photograph to anyone online without your parents' or guardian's consent. Please do not respond to any messages that make you feel uncomfortable. If you do not know someone, never, never, never arrange a meeting face to face if you don't know them personally. Remember that the people who you meet online may not be the same as they are offline. So that's it from my end for today. I really hope that you remember these guidelines, and as I said, the number is 1098. If you feel uncomfortable or unsafe, please give a call and be safe and be smart about using internet. Thank you.